Alright, so we've arrived in Chiang Mai. It is about 2:05 in the afternoon on the 4th of June, thereabouts. And I have my airport transfer here. Is my friend who's come to pick me up here from the hotel. He's going to take me back to the hotel, which is about 10 minutes away. And unlike Bangkok, it's not flat here. As you can see in the background there, we have some mountains over there, so it is quite up in the hills here, and this is going out of Chiang Mai Airport. The terminal's back over there, lots of scooters lined up over there, look like some for hire as well. And you already can already tell right outside the airport that it's a lot more laid back here. You can already feel that it's a lot more laid back here. Construction going on over here. It's quite green. Air Force administration there with an aircraft out the front. Again, lots of water. Big green part of the world. Just see my first tuned car. Not very tuned, it's a Mazda 3, but you can see by the way it sits and it's tuned up a bit. It's a lot more laid back here. High kind of speed. Wall there. Yes, we do have a bit of traffic. Look, a ute. Not just the good old Aussie ute anymore, is it? Saw the other day that Volkswagen have brought one out. Not much chance of that being too accepted in Australia though. You'd be surprised. Probably some people will get one, but it will never be to the core of the ute scene, I shouldn't think. There's a tuk-tuk over there, so I still see them around up here. There's nowhere near as many up here. Some kind of show on. Looks like there might be a shopping centre there of some kind. Chiang Mai is the second largest city in Thailand, so I imagine it does get quite busy. You can see it is quite busy on the roads, but nowhere near as full on as Bangkok. It's not as built up. Then you have little local shopping centres like this where you drive in and park and the shops there rather than having to park on the street. Western influences here, you see McDonald's everywhere, you see Burger King everywhere. The street signs are in English as well as Thai. A lot of packaging on food and drinks is printed in both Thai and English. You can see on this side of this bottle of water it says drinking water. It says all in English. And you turn the bottle around and on the other side it's all in Thai, for example. But definitely emerging big time. You just see it. Everyone's got phones, everyone's got laptops, iPads, iPhones, this phone, that phone, whatever. It doesn't have to be an iPad, it could be a Samsung or whatever. They've all got, a lot of people have got them. All the cars are here, you know, it's definitely emerging big time. We'll have to see what happens with the Western economies in the next year or two as to what happens over here. We'll see, I guess. It's like quite a busy intersection. There's a freeway section over the top, but we didn't get on that. I guess that would be an airport bypass. Still quite a bit of traffic around if you see coming from that way. Blue and yellow taxis are here, but they're not all cars. A lot of them are four-wheel drives. Quite a few people on scooters and they all get to the front. Well, not everyone. A lot of them get to the front, scoot around. There's a mix of new cars and old cars like in any city, I guess. More new ones than old ones. I guess that's progress, what we call progress. like driving along Parramatta Road. It's lined with shops. There's a sidecar. Hey, the first sidecar I've seen since I've been here. Later. So, go and sign off and get checked in.